I think we're very lucky to be where we are, but it also just ended up being a really crazy, weird time to be trying to do a ski trip in the Arctic, because pretty much everything went wrong. And we made it less than halfway across when we found out that Greenland had closed its borders. There were a lot of things that we thought could go wrong, but none of these were even options in our mind that we would get shut down because of a worldwide pandemic.
This kind of dream trip for a lot of us to take the boat for 3 weeks and sail from Iceland to Greenland.
I hope we get to ski some really big, beautiful couloirs up from the ocean.
It's really difficult to understand how big and vast our surroundings are until we can really start to see ourselves move through them.
Yeah, I'm just excited to see the glaciers and icebergs and the wilderness there. Huge granite faces that would be landmarks anywhere else in the world, but they're just out in the middle of the wilderness, so no one ever sees them. I'm really excited to meet people and talk to them, especially because we have Julia, who's from Greenland, with us.
Growing up in Greenland, you just go 5 minutes out of the city and there's nothing. Me living in Greenland can, sometimes it feels like being disconnected kind of from the rest of the world, but for me, this trip will, I will connect.
I just dropped you off.
Ridiculous.
You're not filming, are you?
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, don't worry, because my stash.
5 years ago, I saw someone doing what I'm doing now, I would have thought it was a dream job. I do freelance photography and journalism. I joined Black Diamond as one of their ski athletes, so the ability to be outside every day and still call that work, being able to use athletic endeavors as a way to connect with other parts of the world, I think was a big draw to me. Keree has also worked in Iceland for the last 5 years, and I met her in Ísafjörður, even though we both live in the western U.S. So it all really comes down to this little town, how we all know each other.
Oh, we got so much room.
I just Googled skiing in Iceland and came up with a company here. Then back in the States in March, I got a phone call that said, hey, we can use you in 2 weeks if you want to come. So I just quit my job and flew over to Iceland with a one-way ticket and that's where I started tail guiding. So I've worked as a deckhand for the last 5 years up in Alaska doing commercial gill netting. I also just became a private pilot. So I'm gonna be working towards doing a commercial rating, and I'd love to start doing some backcountry. It kind of fits. I ended up, you know, having a life in the mountains and the ocean and up in the air. Well, looking at the weather, the guys are talking about a 8-meter swell, which is like a 25-foot waves, and we're in about a 60-foot sailing boat. I've never been in 25-foot waves in a 60-foot boat before.
Being on the boat and being able to go up the coast and look as we go and decide to ski things, it's kind of the only way to access that terrain.
Sailing across the Arctic is definitely a lot different to sailing somewhere warm. Just a lot more serious. The fact is that you're in something that's floating, and if it's not floating, you're in a really fucking cold water. Whereas if you're somewhere warm, you feel that safety inside you that you're not gonna have 3 minutes to die.
We're all kind of going into this unknown territory. You do have to kind of dive into something and just do it, give it your all, and you'll learn along the way.
It's so exciting. It's real.
You're gonna figure it out along the way, and there's gonna be things you didn't know were there.
Who's at the helm?
Nobody.
Do we have everyone, by the way?
If you have a second thought, now is the time.
Oh, I don't have.
ocean scares me for sure. Yeah, I'm pretty nervous for the sailing part. I also get pretty seasick. For me, the sail across is like not a great part, but it's worth it to get to the other side.
Also, like, come up ideas for other trips. Having that intensity with partners and realizing like who will be more like lifelong adventure partners too. So yeah, I'm hoping at the end of this trip we'll end up in Greenland, we'll have skied, and we'll also have got future plans to do some fun things.
Of coronavirus.
Their health assessed those with no symptoms.
Infected with coronavirus right now, but after the ship docks today.
I think we all sort of showed up right on the cusp of this big pandemic.
We sailed for, I don't know, about 20 hours and got a message from a contact back on land that said that Greenland had closed its border to foreigners. So we would not be allowed to enter the country on the boat. That combined with the fact that our skipper was coming down with the flu and pneumonia-like symptoms, we made the decision to turn back around and return to Iceland.
It's like the US not shutting out US citizens.
Sort of thought that I would get here and like the world would just settle down while we were gone.
I think I will take the plane as soon as possible.
Yeah. It's stressful right now. I'm just trying to get home.
So we're just stuck here in Iceland.
So we're pretty much stuck on either the boat or in Camilla's house. Yeah, definitely getting a little stir crazy. And with all the coronavirus madness in the world and things changing really quickly, there were just so many unknowns about if we'd be able to get home and if the flights were still gonna be going out. So everyone's getting a little bit nervous and pretty ready to get home.
It's really scary. There's a lot of people sick and a lot of things are shut down.
Okay, so yeah, nobody go to coffee shops or libraries.
I was just wanting to see if I can use the gym.
Here we're like,
people hard to tell when we're gonna be able to get home, and I think everyone's having issues sort of rebooking their flights and figuring out what airports you can still fly into and stuff, so.
Our flight was supposed to leave 2 hours ago, so.
Yeah, seems like most things went wrong that could have and might still keep going wrong because we are still stuck here.
Honestly, like, it almost gives more time to just focus on what we want to put together and what can be. Yeah, just to plan more. Everything kind of came together last minute anyway, so.
I think what makes this trip really cool is to have a group of women together.
Mary and I feel similarly that we would like to go to Greenland and we would like to do this trip next year.
Can I see you back here in a few?
Yeah, I'll just come back and collect you.
We all kind of just realized that there's nothing we can do and to make the most of it.
The world had called something off and the world decided to take a break. It just gives us an opportunity to create something better and continue working on it.
In the end, it shut us down too, but luckily everyone is healthy and happy and safe, and we'll be able to try again next year. Greenland will still be there, and maybe the seas will be